As the last component of our sample project, we will now reinforce the sloped floor and open the sheet RC04. The reinforcement of planar components can be created using area systems. We select the floor as the host and select the edges of the slab as a contour of the area reinforcement. A tip, in the Select Lines option, you can capture the outer contour with a single click using the Tab key. The symbol on the first line represents the main direction. In other words, the direction of the first top and bottom layers. The direction can be changed if necessary. In the properties, we can adjust the bar diameter and spacing of each of the four layers. Confirm the area system with the green checkmark and receive a warning. Better identify the problem, we switch to the section view. For sloped floors, the area reinforcement is not adjusted to the vertical floor edges. Therefore, we select the area system and use shape handles to adjust its size, here at the bottom and here for the top. For checking, it can help to display the concrete cover using the cover tool. To model the edge rebars, we switch back to the top view and use path reinforcement. Again, we select the floor as the host and sketch the path along which the bars are going to be placed at. To do this, we pick up the contour of the area reinforcement. By the way, the status bar in the bottom left displays which element the object snap is currently snapping to. The path must be closed, so we will leave the fourth line a slight bit shorter. The properties, we can choose a spacing of 150 millimeters, a diameter of 12 millimeters, and a length of 750 millimeters. Additionally, choose the rebar shape, the open stirrup, and briefly check the alignment. Using the two small arrows, we bring the reinforcement to the inside of our line and confirm. In the 3D view, we can see that the stirrup is misangled. We rotate the bending shape to the correct position using the spacebar. The SOFiSTiK Reinforcement Browser on the RC4 sheet, we can see that the stirrups have received a common mark. Therefore, all stirrups were created with the same height. Section 3 clearly shows that there are collisions in the corner. In order to be able to edit individual rebars, we remove the rebar system with the SOFiSTiK tool Explode. Now we can select the lower and upper rebars and edit their height individually via their constraints. The top and bottom segments get an additional offset of 12 millimeters. Now the same for the top and confirm. In the SOFiSTiK Reinforcement Browser, we can see immediately that we have obtained a fourth mark. Wonderful! The linear spacer for the top layers are not created as 3D objects, but are added as a symbol on the sheet using the SOFiSTiK tool Linear Spacer. We choose the desired type and the correct height and place for the symbol on our sheet. Again, we find this immediately in the reinforcement browser. The number of spacers is calculated based on the area. The area of the floor can be found in its properties. Here it is approximately 27 square meters, which we now enter into the properties of the linear spacer. I select 28 square meters, resulting in a quantity of 20. Of course, these 20 spacers are now also included in the reinforcement schedule of sheet RC4.